I think it's a cool little community we have in Central Alberta. A lot of the people that we went to high school with, that we were playing in punk bands with over a decade ago, are still professional musicians.
If I had to describe Central Alberta as a music scene in literally just one word, I'd have to say it's inspiring, you know. Plain and simple, it's inspiring.
The Red DM music scene is awesome.
If I had to describe it in one word, I would say passionate.
Talent, because there's a lot of talent in town, for sure. So I'll say talented.
I would say, you know what, I was gonna say a word, but now I've switched. I wanna say enthusiastic.
Eclectic would be a great one. I mean,
yeah,
you know, there's a wide variety of musical styles. If we aren't already, we should be very proud of.
The scene here is divergent in that I see all of it, everything from heavy metal to new world to singer-songwriter to country to classic country. It's all represented within the scene here in Red Deer, which is really, really cool.
It's surprising for both the people that are getting involved with the music scene, the performers and the artists. They're surprised to see how inclusive and dynamic the scene is. The other aspect of that would be the people that are discovering the scene for the first time, the patrons, the people that go and sit and enjoy the music. They're just blown away at how much is really happening. We've got hundreds of events happening every month here in Red Deer. I'm Kyle Key. I'm the publisher of the Red Deer Scene, which is Red Deer's own monthly live entertainment guide. The Red Deer Scene has existed for the past 15 years. It originally started as just a two-page magazine, and now it's grown to over 12 pages, including all of the live entertainment events happening in the city, live music, open mics, a little bit of everything is in there. It's actually really surprising as to how much is really going on in our city. I go out and I deliver the scene and I drop it off at certain businesses, and there's always somebody there that says, oh, is that the new scene? Is that the new scene? And they pick it up and they look through it right away because they're so grateful to be able to have this information. In a lot of cases, in a lot of communities, this publication wouldn't exist and people would just have to kind of go out and have to find that information themselves.
So we've done England, Ireland, Scotland, and Wales now. That's what we're coming off from. And we're releasing our new album. So we thought we'd come home to where we're from, to Alberta, and do an album release tour. When you talk to other touring bands, I'll be like, oh, I'm from Lacombe. And then they'll be like, oh, I don't know Lacombe. I'll be like, well, you know, Red Deer. They're like, we love Red Deer. Like, people love stopping in Red Deer. And once they've stopped, they always come back. And we just heard back today that we're charting in a couple radio stations around. So exciting news for us. And we're finishing up our tour in Alberta. And then we will be heading back to the UK with our posse of random British kids that I've adopted and seeing what happens next.
My name is David Gilmore and I am a certified master luthier. I build guitars. I like to think of them as working pieces of art, but I also like to think of them as usable tools. I'm not precious about a guitar. I don't think it needs to remain pristine. I think guitars need to be played, and the more they're played, the better they're going to get. And that's how I approach the construction of guitars. And they're all unique. Not one of them is going to be the same as another. And, you know, once you get a handcrafted guitar, it's not going to be like anything else. And it's something that, you know, you should have forever. A friend of mine who is actually the first person to believe in Gilmore Guitars as a builder, I built Dan Walsh a guitar, and he's traveled the world with his guitar. And we've become friends over the years, and he and Bob Egan from Blue Rodeo created Guitars for Kids in Cambridge. So essentially what we do is we take donations of guitars that are either just collecting dust under a bed, not being used. I make sure that the guitars are in playable condition, cleaned up, fresh strings, and set up so they're playable. And we just give them to individuals who otherwise can't afford to buy a guitar. We call it Guitars for Kids, but it's guitars for people that need a guitar.
So incredible writing with the Gilmore, just the whole aspect, because you can feel the energy of what David kind of puts in there, and he builds it with his own hands. So I can't even express how grateful I am to him. He's supported me for years now and given me an axe to kind of tour with wherever I am. I'm Jesse Rhodes. I call Central Alberta Red Deer specifically home. I've got some new music coming out. It's pretty cool. I got a whole acoustic album happening and working on some new projects with some other people as well. We talk about how crazy the scene is here and how incredible it is, and everywhere's got their award shows, and I felt like Red Deer, you know, has this amazing, incredible scene. It's more of a situation where these people that are working so hard and dedicating their entire lives, some of them, to music and entertainment in general, you know, they deserve to be recognized. And looking forward to having Shaw come there and be a part of it. Been with us since year one and supporting us, so that's been pretty incredible. And I think it's really cool to have a document that, you know, to document the whole process and see the whole show and then watch it back. You know, it's pretty amazing to see.
The music scene is extremely important to us. We basically base our whole identity around the music scene and live music. The VAT was the first place I ever went to in Red Deer when I was going out, and that's a classic, iconic live music venue. We're grateful for it all, really, and it's a good, tight community, for sure.
Honestly, I think it's come such a long way. I lived here 20 years ago, and there wasn't an awful lot going on, and I actually attended Red Deer College at the Arts Centre. I went to did the theatre program there, which was in conjunction with the music program. And there wasn't that much going on back then, but since returning 10 years ago, the scene has just taken off. There is so much talent in Red Deer. It's kind of what I'm becoming known for now is these house concerts, because they're so intimate and it's a win-win. The artist gets a really attentive audience. So there's not enough room in here for everyone in the audience to be talking to each other, and, you know, the band's right there. The artist will tell stories about how they wrote their songs, and I've had, you know, big rock stars, local rock stars, crying in here as they're telling their most intimate stories, and it's beautiful.
The amount of talent in Red Deer, it's kind of mind-blowing, really, how there's, like, you know, there's just, Red Deer College puts out some amazing musicians. And people that aren't, like, I mean, we're not college goers either, but we're just passionate about music, and it really shows in the people of Red Deer and the performers that come on stage. Like, they just leave it all on the stage, and I think it's awesome.
It's beautiful to be a part of, and I'm very, very grateful that we thought of this idea and it's continuing on.
It's almost like a group of friends hanging out, taking in the music.
Just having people come up and say, hey, you know, that was really great. You know, who are you guys? Where are you from? And that was kind of a real eye-opening experience to what the Red Deer scene is all about.
One of the most important things in our life is the music.
I'm always curious when people say there's nothing to do in Red Deer, because you can literally see live music 7 nights a week.
But obviously, something's happening here. Some's in the water.
I know Netflix is awesome, but you know what? Come out and see a live show, because you might just get blown away.